even, I feel like I have not filmed a sit down video forever. Gina back with Reggie's VSG Closet. Are y'all over Disney content? Just be honest. Let me know down in the comments if y'all are over March Disney takeover. We are ending this with just basically a recap. And y'all, these vlogs have just been so much fun to film, so much fun to edit. Disney is still amazing despite having to wear masks. So I just thought I would do a basic recap video, letting y'all know like my pros, my cons. Just, I have notes. Y'all know it's important when I have notes. But I just kind of wanted to run down a few of these things that I just wanted to talk about that I didn't really get into detail in the vlogs and stuff. So we're just gonna hop right on in. Alright, so first up on my list are shoes, y'all. So I went to these parks and y'all know I love my Vans. I absolutely love my Vans. They're comfortable. Most of them are comfortable for a certain period of time when it comes to walking. Not all day walking. So definitely, 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 if you've never been to Disney, wear running shoes. That's basically my best advice. Buy yourself some nice running shoes. I definitely plan on buying myself some really nice running shoes, the ones with like the air pockets in them, just real nice ones that are just comfortable and will last you all day. Like, my Vans are great, but for like 9-10 hours worth of walking, I mean, I was matching and I was cute, but my feet were crazy. They were screaming. I think I still have like a bruise on my pinky toe from just the walking. And sometimes, especially in the summer, I don't wear socks with my shoes. And it's just, I'm great now. I'm good. I'm good to go now. But I really wish I would have just bought a nice pair of running sneakers to wear that were just comfortable and cushy and could last me all day in what, four parks? We went to four parks. Three Disney and Universal. Well, Universal and Adventure Island are the same, so meh. Alright, so back-to-back parks. That takes us into back-to-back parks, y'all. Book a day of rest. I mean, even if it's not a day of rest, even if it's a day of like sightseeing or shopping or, you know, going to cute little restaurants, I don't know, in between your park days. Because back-to-back parks, y'all, I was good with Hollywood Studios. That was our first park. Fine. We came in, we got a good night's rest, hopped up, went to Hollywood Studios. I think we had a day of rest. And then we had Epcot. We had Epcot. Epcot, fine. I'm okay. We had a day of rest. I'm chilling. We're pretty good. So right after Epcot, we had Universal Studios. And that is where it all began. Y'all, I was depleted, like drained. And I'm usually a pretty energetic person, even if I don't get a lot of sleep at night, because I am a night owl. I don't go to bed until like 2-3 o'clock in the morning sometimes. And y'all, I was just done. I was depleted. My feet still kind of hurt. That wasn't the main thing. I could still walk around with no issues. Like, just drained of energy. Like, I've never felt this drained unless I was just like sick. Like sick, had a cold or something. And it was not that. It was just, I was just like, I had nothing in me. We did end up stopping and getting something to eat, and I loaded up, and slowly but surely my energy came back. But y'all, like, that was terrible. It was really bad, and it made me worry about Magic Kingdom, because that next day was my birthday, and I was like, am I gonna feel like this on my birthday? Like, what? But, you know, it was a tiny slow start with Magic Kingdom. But I got there being like 100% myself, like faster than I did at Universal Studios. Y'all, I was like, Like, I was like, I didn't want to ride rides. Like, I was borderline ready to leave early. Like, it wasn't good. It really wasn't good. It would have been a waste of a lot of money. So, I know next time we are going to space out these parks. We are going to plan, either do less parks or plan more days so that I can have a day in between each park. I mean, I am down for being on vacation and just hanging out in the hotel the whole time. Like, that's still a vacation to me. Some people, that's not a vacation. They want to be up, they want to be going, they want to hit here, there, do lunch, do this, do that. Just being in a hotel room, I'm on vacation. Like, I'm good with, like, literally, like, driving 2 miles down the street to, like, a local hotel and, like, staying the night and being like, oh my gosh, this is vacation. It's just something about a nice hotel room, not, like, just, like, Motel 6. I don't, like, I was joking the other day because I was like, I like the doors to my hotel rooms to be inside the hotel. Like, I gotta walk inside the hotel. That's the big difference between, what is it, hotels are like enclosed and motels are, I don't know, but I am over those days of staying in a motel. Like, maybe in my late teens, early 20s, I was about like, okay, we'll get a motel real quick. Nah, sis. No. And if, like, you book some, if somebody else books something and I show up and it's a motel, I'll handle my own. I'll see y'all later. But seriously, like, just book days in between parks, because y'all, just the way 35 is set up, I need space. I need time in between each park. All right, next on the list, Disney Warehouse, y'all. If you go, go. If you go to Florida, Orlando, you don't even have to go to Disney. If you just are in the Orlando area and you go to, what is it, Vineland Premium Outlets, y'all sign up. Right now it's a textless. I think prior to COVID, you could like walk in, no problems, like a regular store. Now it's like a textless. You show up, you get on the textless. If you go early enough in the morning, I believe you can just like, they let a certain amount of people in. But if you don't go early in the morning, then you go, you get on a text list, they shoot you a text to verify your phone number, and then your second text is the text that tells you, hey, it's time for you to come show up. You have 15 minutes from the time you get that second text to be at the store for them to let you in. Or you have to start all over. So my thing was, is I asked the lady, hey, what's a rough estimated time for me to be back? And she was like, it's about a 3-hour wait. I was like, okay, cool. My hotel is 15 minutes away. We were leaving the outlet at the time. Went back to the hotel, chilled for a little bit, and then went probably 2.5 hours in. I went back, parked, because parking at that outlet is ridiculous on the weekends. Went back, parked, got in. I had time, I think, from the vlog, if y'all saw it, I had time to go get me a little Aunt Annie's, little something. And like, I want to say 40 minutes before they closed, I got the text, and I was like, yes. So I hope you guys enjoyed that vlog. It was so much fun to shop in that store. Again, if you have time or a chance to be in that area and get on that text list and experience that store, y'all, the deals, just the deals. Like, y'all know I'm a shopper, and I don't buy a lot of Disney merch because it's so expensive. This is like my only my only pride and joy purchase in my ears. But y'all, the deals, just, that's all I'm gonna say, the deals. All right, so y'all saw in the Universal vlog that we started out walking through City Walk. We did not go back. I wanted to go back on the day that we had available for shopping, but really City Walk is just like restaurants. The only thing that we wanted to go back for, y'all, there's a Voodoo Donuts at City Walk. Like, the only other place I've experienced Voodoo Donuts is when I went to Seattle in 2019, and we actually drove to Oregon to the Voodoo Donuts there. We drove to Oregon just for Voodoo Donuts, because that's just the type of people we are. I don't I don't know. It was fun. It was a cute little road trip. Me and my family, we just was kind of getting out for the day. We went and saw some waterfalls and some other things on the way there. So we didn't just drive for donuts. We ain't that bad. But just like a fun little shop, very interesting donuts. Out of all of the donuts they offered, I actually just got a glaze because that, I mean, I'm fun and I'm bubbly and y'all love my vibe, but I am mainly, usually 100%, 99.9% just a straight glazed donut type of chick. Like, I don't like the cakey donuts. I don't like anything with, oh my gosh, jelly filled donuts. No thank you. Who? Why? What's the point? Like, ew. Like, what is it? Jimmy Fallon? Ew. So I prefer just a glazed donut. So that's what I ended up getting my experience in Portland. But we didn't get a chance to go back. But Voodoo Donuts is fun if you get to experience it. They have some crazy concoctions of donuts, bubblegum, grape jelly, just weird, just beyond that, just weird stuff, like ghost pepper, like a lot of crazy stuff. Look them up. It's fun. If you're ever in that area, check them out. But pretty much with City Walk, that's pretty much it. There was like a few shops and we were like, it's not really worth going back. But, you know, if you want a fun place to go walk around and eat and go to restaurants, go to dinner, go to lunch, if you're in that area, definitely hit up City Walk. Disney Springs. So Disney Springs, very similar to City Walk, but the Disney version. It's basically like an open air shopping, eating, everything. There are more stores and shops at Disney Springs. We did go back to Disney Springs and kind of walk around a little bit. We went to like a World of Disney store, and I'll show you guys in my next video. We've decided at this point here, since I've done a lot of talking, that we're gonna do our haul from vacation separate. So in the next video, you will see the haul of things that I got. I did get a few things from the World of Disney at Disney Springs. And there's just like lots of fun, cute shops there. Very touristy. You could literally spend all day there as if you were like in the Disney parks, because it's like massive. There's a lot going on there, a lot to see, lots to do at Disney Springs. All right, y'all, so next on my list is the Star Wars Experience Q, Rise of Resistance, y'all. So to get into this queue, you have to wake up at the crack of dawn. Let's just start there, because you have to be in your Disney app. And you have to basically pull down, I'm doing the motion, pull down on the app for it to refresh. And at 7 a.m. on the dot, they release the flood of however many tickets or passes or queue line waits they have for the morning session. So I get in, we get our tickets, it gave me an estimated like 140 minutes to make it to get in line. Okay, fine, we've got plenty of time. The park doesn't open until 9 a.m. It's 7:15, you know, we're good, blah, blah, blah. Y'all, that little update on time updated so fast. So, I'm telling y'all, like, when we got the tickets, I was at the point like, ooh, I could possibly like take a little quick nap and then get up and get ready. And it was like, nah, sis, you gotta like go now, cause you need to be there yesterday. So that like put like threw a wrench in my day. So as y'all see for that vlog, I didn't even vlog that part of the day. I was just so over it. I like was done. I had to rush out of the hotel. I left key things. I left my water. I left things that I planned to take with me. It was chaotic. It's an experience if you're a Star Wars fan. I'm aware of Star Wars. I'm not some like huge fan, but it was an experience. I mean, I think because of COVID, they don't like get as interactive as they did when the ride first opened, but it's still worth trying to get into the queue, going, experiencing it, you know, say you did it type thing. But y'all, I mean, if you're a diehard fan, you're gonna love it. If you're like just like me, you're aware of Star Wars, it's okay. I could have waited, like, out in the park somewhere while you go. Like, I didn't have to go with you. That's kind of the vibe and feeling that I feel about it. But I don't know. Like, maybe if I wasn't rushed and in a better mood that morning, I would have, like, really, like, took it all in. I would have vlogged. I would have had more fun with it. But I just wasn't feeling it. I don't know. I was excited when I got in the queue, though. But when it took me through a period of life where I had to be rushed, I was done. Like, no, this is not what my life is about anymore. I get to things and I do things at my own pace, because that's how I like to live my life. All right, so next on my list, y'all, I was very, very disappointed. I did tweet them, but they never responded, because it's just little me, like, Reggie's VSC closet. Who? What? Anyway, I, on my birthday, the day before my birthday, I got my email from Starbucks, like, free drink on your birthday. Hey, it's the birthday chick. You know, all of that. And I was like, okay, I didn't have time to stop on the way in. So I was like, oh, there's a Starbucks in Magic Kingdom. I'll be able to get my drink at the Starbucks in Magic Kingdom. Get to the counter. Stood in line, because there is a line. Got to the counter, was like, order this. Oh, I got my app for my birthday drink. Oh, sorry, we can't accept those. Starbucks, right? App, right? I can pay with my app, but I can't use the coupon from birthday drink. What? Like, wait, what? Y'all are Starbucks, right? Like, I don't know, but they weren't able to let me use my birthday drink. It was the end of the night. We were in Magic Kingdom. By the time we left, all the Starbucks in the area were closed. So I really sadly am sad that I wasted. I did not get to use my birthday drink. And I tried to tweet them to see if they could, like, send me something, like, so I can get, like, a birthday drink on a different day. They didn't bother to respond. But anyway, really sad about that. Kind of hurt Starbucks. It really hurt my feelings that day. It was my birthday and I didn't get to use my birthday drink. How fun would it have been for me to be able to get my free birthday drink at the Starbucks in Magic Kingdom? Like y'all need to, like, work on those rules for that Starbucks, because, like, that makes absolutely no sense. Alright, so next on my list is the hotel. So we did not stay on, like, in a Disney resort or on property. I actually have never stayed on property for Disney. I would love to. Like, that is on my bucket list, is to stay in one of those, like, fun themed hotels. I don't know. But we ended up staying at just, like, an IHG hotel. I actually used to work for IHG, so I have points, and I stay at a lot of the IHG hotels. Look them up. It's basically Holiday Inn, Candlewood Suites. A lot of those hotels are in that group. And we ended up just staying at a Holiday Inn and Suites. It was, like, 10 minutes down the street from that outlet that I was speaking of, and 15 minutes from the parks. Perfect location, y'all. 2 minutes away from a Target. That Target was tiny, but it was a Target. So, you know, it was just perfect location. I really think that's going to be, like, my go-to hotel from now on when I go to Disney, except for the time when I actually go and stay on site one day. I don't know when that will ever be, but Holiday Inn and Suites. I do not remember the address, but maybe I'll put it in the description if I remember. But great, great hotel. Their pool was clean too, even though I didn't get a chance to go, like, swimming. It was really nice, yeah. All right, so we're going to go over some of the key things that some of these parks were closed. So I did go over Magic Kingdom, the People Mover. Y'all, that's, like, for someone that hates roller coasters and doesn't ride roller coasters, that is a key ride for me. Like, it's slow. It goes around in a circle on a track. It doesn't go up. It doesn't come down. It goes very slowly around a circle a few times. And that's what I love. And the People Mover was closed, y'all. People Mover was closed. Very sad about that. A lot of the, like, shows that they do, Beauty and the Beast, a lot of those like acting, I don't know, musical show type things. A lot of those were closed, sadly. I did mention at Hollywood Studios, the Indiana Jones stunt show, y'all, amazing. That was closed. So there were a few key things that were sadly closed at the parks, but I mean, it doesn't fully like stunt your experience. But if it's like your first time going, it may, because like when it was my first time going, like those experiences made Disney like great for me. Like, because again, I don't ride roller coasters, so anything extra besides roller coasters that I could add into my day just was great. And all of, I went to all of those little shows, and it's a great time to just like sit and chill, get off your feet for like 20-25 minutes. But yeah, a lot of those like key things for me were closed. All right, so next on our list is the lines. Oh my God. So Universal Studios and all of the Disney parks are like basically working at like a, I don't know, 30, 40%, 50% capacity. I have no idea. But y'all, the lines are still like, and I think they feel longer because they have these strips on the ground that are 6 feet apart, and you're supposed to stand 6 feet apart, even though some people don't like, they don't pay attention to those lines, because we would like stand on our strip, and then the people behind us, their nose would like be tapping us on our shoulder like, coronavirus, 6 feet, please. Like, you know, some people you had to turn around and give them like a little look, like, back up, fool. Like, what is wrong with you? So that was a little thing that we ran into when we were in line for a lot of our rides and stuff. But y'all, the lines, I think, I want to say they felt longer because of the 6 feet, but the lines, they're, but then now going and seeing how spaced out they have people, like, it made me think like, oh my gosh, like the last time we came here prior to COVID, like, we were like up on people, like, ew, why were we so close to people in line? Like, 6 feet should be natural, like the natural spacing of everybody, regardless of a virus or not. Like, 6 feet is nice. Like, why were we so close to people standing in line prior to this? Like, I don't even know. All right, so I made notes because when I went to Epcot, y'all, Epcot has two parts. Epcot has like the family side with all the rides, and then they have a second little part that's like the world. Like, each little area is like a different country. Is it country? Country, like Germany, Japan, China, there's a few more. I can't remember them all, but basically each little section is set up like that country. There's eateries and food stations and all kinds of things in those different areas. A few of the areas have rides. Mexico had a ride I showed you guys. I think, there was some other rides in each little area, but y'all, I saw this girl group. It was like a bachelorette party, y'all. They were drinking around the world, y'all, drinking around the world. Like, I'm ready for me and my friends to just like get this set up. Like, I'm ready to do t-shirts, I'm ready to do all kinds of stuff so we can get together and just go drink around the world at Disney, because they look like they had so much fun. Like, every time I saw them, and it was like almost in a different country, like, they were doing shots, they were doing all kinds of stuff, y'all. They were having a good adult mommy free time. I don't even know, no men, it was just them and their bachelorette party crew. And y'all, I'm ready, like calling all of my friends now. All right, y'all, so during this trip, I really discovered that I absolutely, positively, 100% extra wanna, I really want a Loungefly bag, y'all. Like, they are so cute. I'm gonna have to show y'all, like, right here, the number one that I want. Oh, it's amazing. Like, it should be here. Don't y'all see it in all of its glory? It is perfect. It is so me. There are so many options, but y'all, this bag, I really want it. I ended up, and I'll show you guys in my haul, using a discount that I got from Disney for my birthday and bought a cheaper version of a Loungefly bag. But y'all, I want him. He's so cute. He's so cute. He should still be up here. He's so cute. Oh my gosh, I really want a Loungefly bag, y'all. All right, so another strange thing that I want the next time I go to Disney, y'all, I want a popcorn bucket. Like, I'm 35. Why do I want these things, y'all? I have no idea. But some of those popcorn buckets are so stinking cute. And the smell of popcorn was just, it was mesmerizing. I didn't even get any popcorn at any of the parks, but it just smelled so good. But the little, like, popcorn bucket, like, people were, like, carrying in them. It was just so cute. And I think once you buy the popcorn bucket, like, all your refills are, like, a few dollars. So, like, I guess, like, is it, like, anytime you come back, can you bring your bucket with you? And, like, you're pretty much getting free popcorn almost. Like, I don't know how that works, but I want a popcorn bucket. Alright, so another thing I realized that I really want to do the next time I go to Disney is I want to have a sit-down dinner. Like, some of those little, like, dinner places, restaurants were just so pretty. They were so cute. They were just magical. Like, especially the one in, like, the Aztec place that I showed you guys in the Mexico Pavilion area. Y'all, it was, like, nighttime in there. They were, like, pumping in sounds of the night, sounded like crickets. It was so nice, and I really want a sit down meal at Disney. So every time I go back to Disney, I realize, like, when we're driving from the hotel to the parks, y'all, like, Disney has their own, like, highway. Like, if you've never drove from, like, you know, anywhere, like, just pay attention. Like, the signage is so cute, and it's a super highway to Disney. Like, you veer off here to go to Epcot, you get over here to go to Magic Kingdom, stay straight for Animal Kingdom. Y'all, it's a whole, like, super highway system, and they are building more. Like, they were doing construction on part of it when we were driving through. So I'm like, where is Disney going now? Like, where's this road gonna take me? I'm so excited. But y'all, like Walt Disney, he had a dream, y'all, and he executed it like nobody's business. So if you out there, and if you can execute your dream to just 1% of what Disney did for his own dream, you making it. Like, hey, Reggie's BSG Closet, we gonna make it. Because if we can just have a goal of, like getting this to 1% of what Disney did, like, we're set. We are good to go. All right, y'all, so that is it for this video. Y'all, I had so much fun on this trip. There were so many ups, so many downs. I was spinning and twirling all around. But, like, despite having to wear a mask pretty much the whole time through all the parks, with the exception of, like, sitting and eating, it was still a good time. So take your families, go have a good time. Do not hesitate. It's still, like, an amazing, magical place. Again, stay tuned for our next video that I'm about to film in a second of my haul, y'all. Y'all don't see it, but y'all are about to. But that's it. That's all I have for you guys. I'm gonna leave y'all with a few pictures of some of my cups and products that I took with me on the trip, just to get some, like, really cool shots. I'm so proud of them. They should be popping up here and here and there. I don't know, everywhere. Here, I don't know. Anyway, I will catch you guys in the next one. As always, I love y'all so much, and I really hope you guys enjoyed all of this Disney content. And we're almost in April. What are we doing in April? I have no clue. I don't know. But I will catch you guys in the next one. Please like, comment, subscribe, share, and bye.